The purpose of this hearing is to take a hard look at the generic drug industry and to make certain that generics remain affordable to the patients who need them. More than 1 out of 4 Americans do not fill their prescriptions because they cannot afford the cost.
When drug companies increase their prices by hundreds or even thousands of percent, virtually overnight, we as members of Congress have an obligation to our constituents to find out why and to determine what we can do to help the people we serve. Corporate executives claim they are reinvesting 100% of these massive profits into production improvements and new medicines, but they refuse to provide any documents to support this dubious claim, and they decline to send anyone here today to testify.
I'm sure that some generic drug manufacturers would like to blame their price increases on the FDA and its 10 full-time employees in India. But I think we need a deeper investigation into the price hikes. And frankly, I think we need more support for those FDA inspectors who are trying to keep our drugs safe.
Last year, I spent $849 on prescription medications. This year, after going back to do the math, I anticipate that my out-of-pocket costs will exceed $1,700.
The trend line is going up rather than down in terms of the proportion that have these increases. I think it's grossly unfair to call that anecdotal or just a few cases. These drugs are going up at, as we've heard, hundreds of percents or thousands of percents at a time. Now imagine if you're a diabetic patient and the cost of your diabetic medicine goes up 50%. As a diabetic patient, you don't have any choice. Either you don't buy the medicine and you get worse and you suffer the consequences, or you pay the price. But even if you pay the price, your diabetes doesn't get 50% better when you pay 50% more.
I am the buyer and seller of these prescription drugs. I am seeing it in real dollars and cents in black and white on my invoices when I buy drugs, and I am seeing it on the receipts when I sell prescriptions to patients. We're talking about increases of 2,000, even 8,000%. These spikes usually happen overnight with little or no notice.
How can anyone on a fixed income deal with these vagaries in the system? You sure can't budget for costs that change month to month. And it's not just a few pennies, as you can see. These are significant percentages.
Generic drugs are inexpensive because of competition. The cost of a generic product is closely related to the number of manufacturers producing it. For example, the number of manufacturers producing Digoxin used for heart failure fell from 8 to 3 from 2002 to 2013. During that time, the price rose by nearly 650%.
Congressman Cummings and I and others wanted to know why it is that over the course of a year, the price of these drugs have gone up not 5% in some cases, but 500%, not 10%, but 1,000%. These huge increases in generic drug prices not only drive up healthcare prices throughout America, which is a huge issue, but they impact the lives of very real people, many of whom are struggling economically.